Okay, so this time we're going to try the reverse spider, whatever you want to call it. And we're going to start the same way. We take the shirt and we fold it exactly in half. Okay, and again, we're trying to match everything up. Sleeve, sleeve, underarm, shoulder, shoulder, neck to neck. No folds in between the material. You'll notice it when you do it yourself. Now, the only difference here is that instead of taking it along the seam that we made, we're going to take it on the opposite side. Same idea though. You get a good pinch here and you want to make sure you're tight there. And you begin your spin. You might get a little more bunching up, especially when the short sleeves come around. So you're going to want to be on top of that. Add a little friction or tightness by pulling on the outside corners. Help bring it all together. Hopefully you're keeping your center really tight. And there you go, she's ready for the string. Okay, so the reverse spider is almost identical to the spider, except that the effect is gonna be backwards, so to speak. So instead of radiating outwards from the middle, you're gonna radiate outwards, which is actually inwards from the outside. It's kinda hard to explain, but we'll take a look at it when it's open. Anyways, I'm going to start it the same way. I'm going to use a black. And I'm going to go in the middle here. And I'm going to treat it like a spider. Which means I follow the fold circle or the fold line, so to speak, from the center outwards. I'm not putting a ton of dye on. Just as, you know, as thin as line as possible. It's not that easy. It spreads out right away, so whatever. And it doesn't have to be perfect. No science, it's more or less an art. Whatever it is, it's fun. Okay, so we've done that. And, you know, to highlight that spider, I'd like to put a lighter color in the middle. That's why I've been doing these lighter colors. So I'm putting this red or scarlet. And that's hanging out around here. And I think on the outside of that scarlet, I'm gonna go with a yellow. Actually, no, I'm going with orange. There's a nice bit of orange. And after the orange, then I'm going to use this yellow. Yellow's looking good, and I'm going to finish the whole shirt off with this green. You don't have to pick these dark colors, you don't have to pick light colors, you can find the colors that you want. Four colors is usually enough for a maximum, but you can go higher, depending on your fold and your spin. Sometimes too many colors on certain folds just makes the shirt too busy. And you probably don't want to wear it. But there you go. After I clean the screen and flip it over, I'll repeat that and we'll see what it looks like in the end. Right on.
A little big call of a big goose. I get on my track, I take a backseat, hitchhike, take a long ride on a motorbike until I'm ready. Praise a little thing called love. This thing,
this game,
called love, and I just can't handle it. This thing,
this game,
called love, can't get around to it.
I ain't ready.
Praise a little thing called love. Praise a little thing.